Tonight we continue our series on the greatest Canuck of all time with a look at the Russian Rocket. Here's Squire.
Thanks very much, Tony. Now, of the seven players we selected for this series, nobody gets as much reaction as Pavel Bure. Mention his name, and you'll either have people gush over how great a player he was or complain about how he demanded a trade to get away from the Canucks. No matter what he did while he was in Vancouver, Bure was always the center of attention.
Here goes Bure. Pavel Bure, shorthanded breakaway, score!
Unbelievable.
I hope I can be in this uniform soon.
You know, the first time I met Pavel was down in San Jose, actually, and this smallish guy came in and couldn't speak any English, and we're all like, this is the guy, you know?
Right from the day he first stepped on the ice for the Vancouver Canucks, he wowed the city.
Starting at right wing, please welcome the newest member of the Vancouver Canucks, Pavel Bure.
What Pavel brought at the time, the team never had before. And that was a superstar that was young. And I wouldn't say the word overly confident, but he wasn't afraid to say, look, I'm going to score 50 goals. And he went out and did it.
Pavel Bure. Bure across the line. Bure in the slot. Bure in front. Shoot, score!
Some of the things that Pavel did at high speed, I couldn't do it walking through it sometimes, some of the things, you know, and players are always fooling around before practice or during practice to try different things. But when Pavel did this, it was all at high speed, and he did it in games.
Bure, look at him just wind it up, cuts into the slot, and scores!
Pavel was the type of player that, and there's not a lot of guys who can do that, but literally bring people out of their seats, and incredibly explosive. I mean, and just made things happen where you didn't think anything could happen.
Here he comes on board, over the line, crashes through, is in, scores!
He was scary with the puck. I mean, he could do stuff to made other players look like they were in another league. So it'd be boys playing with men sometimes.
Pavel Bure scored 288 goals, regular season and playoffs combined, for the Vancouver Canucks, some of the most memorable and spectacular in franchise history.
Bure going in! He scores! Pavel Bure!
The Russian Rocket was officially launched on November 5th, 1991, his first ever game with the Canucks.
All that we have left are $32 standing room tickets.
It was a sellout crowd that night. They had come to see if the mysterious Russian was the real thing or just media hype. On that first shift against the Winnipeg Jets, he answered every question and converted every skeptic.
First shift on the ice, he got the puck inside his own blue line and went through the Winnipeg Jets. He didn't score. He didn't score in that game. But I think he had like seven shots on goal. The whole building was just so excited to see this kid that they've heard so much about coming from Russia, all the hype, the pressure. It's in November, well into the season, and he comes on the ice and he didn't disappoint anyone. Finally, Vancouver has a superstar.
The whole, even people on the bench, our team, everyone stood up. I've never seen a guy skate that fast, that confident, and go end to end. I've never seen that before. I don't know if you'll ever see that again, how fast he skated. I don't know how fast he was going. I don't think anyone's ever skated that fast, I think. And I don't think he ever skated that fast himself afterwards. That was insane, that one shift.
In his heyday, Pavel Bure was part athlete, part rock star.
You've got two full bags of it.
Yeah, it's every
full
week.
Of fan mail.
Yeah, it's every week same.
Every week the same thing.
Yeah.
Even if the Canucks lost, he himself was worth the price of admission. Pavel was a human highlight reel.
Walking right in on goal. He did. He scored.
He had those gifts that are usually handed out, one per player. Some guys can skate fast. Some have great shots. Some have strength. Some have determination. Pavel, he had all of those. And he combined it with a sense of showbiz. When the spotlight was on, so was he.
A hat trick goal to win it in overtime.
I never met a guy that loved to score goals like he did.
I would say from the blue line in, there wasn't many more exciting players than him.
You know, Pavel loved to score, and not all guys do, you know, but he loved to score and was driven to score. And, you know, he had that quick step, and once he had a step on the defender, you know, he took it to the net. And, you know, when you're scoring 60 goals a year, it's pretty electrifying.
Lost it to Pavel Bure, coming in on goal, right in, scores! Great goal, Pavel Bure.
The 1994 playoffs were the climax of Bure's time in Vancouver. A lockout and injuries allowed him only one more 50-goal season before his acrimonious split with the team, a trade demand that turned him from hero to pariah. But hindsight will give everyone a clear picture of Pavel Bure's legacy with the Vancouver Canucks.
Cleared by Momesso to center to Linden. Over the line to Pavel Bure. Cutting to the slot. Winding up. Holes. Shoot. Scores! Pavel Bure!
This kid is the best player the Vancouver Canucks have ever had. And I felt very badly when Pavel left Vancouver with so much negative reaction from the fans and the media. They forgot what this kid did for this franchise. Two back-to-back 60-goal seasons, 110 points, led the team in scoring in the Stanley Cup playoffs, and took a beating all through the playoffs when there was a story came out that he was going to withhold his services to get a new contract, which he denied, and he got no support from anywhere on that. And that really turned him off, but it didn't stop him from playing terrific hockey.
Now a breakaway from Pavel Bure, coming in on goal, right in.
He is the greatest in the game right now. Let's be honest about it. Is there anybody more exciting than the Russian Rocket?